Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are back on The Witcher 3 Blood and Wine DLC. In this episode, we're going to be taking a look at the house, the estate that we are in. If you watched the last episode all the way till the end, you saw me initiate the quest here and do a couple of different things here. But we're going to redo what I did in the last episode, as well as do the full estate house tour type thing. Take a look around. He's going to actually show us a detailed look around here, but I'm going to take a little bit look without him real quick. It's nice. I'm hoping you can, like, obtain different stuff and get stuff, like, working in here and, you know, get all sorts of cool things going with this. This could either be, like, really awesome, or it could be, like, meh. It could be a meh thing.
It keeps a devil somewhere,
it just all depends on really what they do, but it...
Wolf himself.
It could be really awesome. They could have made this really awesome, or it could be really, really meh is what I'm trying... I guess I just said that, but that's what I'm trying to say, is that I hope they did some really cool things with this, and that there will be just a lot of things happening here, and a lot of cool things to do. But we will have to wait and see. Some cheese. See what's back here. I think I'm robbing my servants. I think that's what's happening here. Oh, here's another door. Let's grab that. Oh, this is locked. Okay. Alright, let me grab this. Alright, maybe we should just go talk to him. He's going to show us around here anyway. But I thought we've already... If you've already heard all of this... dialogue, feel free to skip ahead. No need for you guys to waste your time. But I thought it was a good place, you know, create and have this be a full episode.
Welcome home, sir. I am Barnabas Basil Fawlty. By order of the Duchess, I shall serve you as Majordomo of Corfo Bianco. I previously served with distinction at the Nibley family manor and in Nazaire with Admiral Rompali, who, as you are certain to know, is an extraordinary, demanding gentleman.
Whoa, Barnabas Basil. One thing you ought to know, I'm not your typical landed gentleman. Truth be told, this is the first real property I've ever owned.
Oh, in that case, you must leave it all to me. I shall organize, see to everything, and whip the house into order. I dare say this place will soon be the most prosperous vineyard around.
Great. Can already see I'm in good hands. Vineyard comes across as a place with a rich history. Know who owned it before me?
Baron Rossell, who went bankrupt, forcing him to sell the estate to the Duchess. The Baron, in turn, had purchased it from Monsieur Bolius of the Headsman, a truly colorful man of Kedweni origin.
He was actually a headsman?
No, not him, but his great-great-great-great-grandfather. Indeed. Apparently, he was a common cutpurse who somehow secured for himself the post of ducal headsman in Beauclair. Went about his work with an exceptional penchant. They say he chopped off more heads than there are grapevines in the ducal vineyards. He never hesitated, not once. Never sliced unevenly, never botched a job. For his exemplary service, the Duke granted him a title and this estate. Monsieur Bolius, on the other hand, was an engineer in his younger years. Once retired, he settled here and took to producing wine. Sadly, misfortune struck and he lost his sense first of smell, then of taste. Additionally, he could not drink alcohol. His medic forbade it.
Shame that. He gave up making wine?
Not at all. He made even more of it. Began throwing wild balls to which he'd invite friends from far and wide in order to treat them to his wine and delight in the fact that at least someone could enjoy it. It's the sort of man he was, Monsieur Bolius.
Mind giving me a little tour de Corvo Bianco?
Not in the least. Follow me, please. I think it would be practical to begin on the hill. Behold, sir, your estate in all its splendor.
Pretty vast.
Indeed. And now, sir, allow me to show you a handful of interesting details. Follow me, please.
Been a majordomo all your life?
Yes, I come from a long line of majordomos. My father was a majordomo, as was my grandfather before him, as was my great aunt. In fact, she was the one to start the tradition.
Great aunt?
A hard woman. It is said that already as a child, she knew where she was going and went there. When she arrived in Beauclair, she signed on as a chambermaid at one of the vineyards, then slowly worked her way up to majordomo. She dragged the rest of the family up the same path.
Lots to do before it gets dark.
The servants' quarters. I occupy the green home. With the Duchess's permission, I have hired a full staff. Their salaries to be paid from the ducal treasury.
Nice of her.
Not the most sightly part of the estate, I admit. But I think it's worthwhile for you as master of the domain to know where the help stays.
All right, what's next?
Baron Rossell ordered the vines in this part of the estate uprooted and olive groves planted in their place. They look beautiful, especially come spring.
Don't look at all bad now, either.
Who would have thought? Knights trading.
Down below lies your vineyard, where we grow a strain of Carfanere, one of the world's oldest. Aged in oak barrels, it provides for an exquisite wine with distinct blackberry, wild cherry, plum, and cinnamon notes. Marvelous.
Have to try it one of these days.
Even a horse drops if you ride it at a constant gallop.
Nice well. Picturesque.
Yes, though it ran dry long ago. During the raucous feasts Master Bolius held, he would order it filled with wine. There's a tale about a guest attending a Bolius ball for the first time and thus unaware of the custom. He had suffered great heartbreak and had decided to end his life by jumping into the well. The festivities were coming to a close, and the well was nearly empty when the suicidal guest finally jumped. Instead of killing himself, he merely broke his legs. To numb the pain, he drank the wine.
Drank himself to death?
Not at all. When found the next day, he had concluded he'd witnessed twin miracles. The water had been changed into wine, and he had survived. He retired to a monastery in the Dragon Mountains and began preaching the wisdoms of Lebioda.
What do we got here? Did I miss some dialogue there? Or is he just kind of showing me? Yeah, this over here is a thing. I think I lost some dialogue there. I think somehow it glitched out.
Madame Nina planted diminutive, delicate flowers and herbs here. One might say their aroma still hangs in the air.
You're quite the romantic, Barnabas Basil.
Our knights errant? They're so heroic. We had to summon a witcher to do their work.
Never ever trust a woman, remember that.
This served as an additional wine cellar in years of plentiful harvests.
Bit of work and it'll make a fine stable for Roach.
Oops, yeah. Be careful, will you?
You'll soon need to cough.
The cellars, voila. During Monsieur Bolis's time, wine was kept here, but Baron Rossel used it to store olive oil as well. I took the liberty of cleaning up the mess, which
I made while fighting the Bruxa. Thanks, Barnabas Basil. Appreciate it.
As you can see, the facade is, how to put it, slightly stained. But one cannot deny it a certain subtle southern charm.
True, though it could use a bit of subtle paint.
Alright, we heading in the house now? Awesome.
And welcome inside.
I'm happy I made this its own episode.
On the left is the master bedroom. On the right, the dining hall and kitchen. Upstairs, you shall find the guest room, currently used for storage.
Not a bad idea.
At the moment, the house is only minimally furnished. Yet I believe we will, together, devise some innovative arrangements. A few paintings, for instance, would breathe new life into the abode immediately. With that, sir, you've seen the full lay of the land. Corfo Bianco is a beautiful estate. Though one must admit, time has taken its toll. If, forgive me for being forward, but if you were to choose to invest a small sum towards its beautification, consider me at your service on the matter.
Think I'll take you up on that. Be sure to come and see you if I decide to do any remodeling. Mentioned the place could stand to be spruced up.
Oh, most decidedly, sir. The question is where you would like to begin this rejuvenation.
Oh, here we go. See here, the grounds. Be nice to improve the... Yeah, let's see about that.
Got these spacious grounds. But maybe it's time to make them more... useful.
Oh, yes! We certainly should. The way I see things, given your trade, sir, you would be wise to put in a grindstone and an armorer's table. A good way to start things off, don't you think?
Okay.
In my trade, my blades get dull pretty quick. Could use a grindstone, professional grade.
Of course. No one would consider that an unnecessary extravagance, I would wager.
$1,000! Holy hell! Let's get it.
Then send out for one, please. A high-quality stone to be set up in the yard.
Of course. I shall send a runner to town at once. I believe you shall be grinding to your heart's content by tomorrow. Will you be needing anything else, sir?
My armor needs work from time to time. You know, oil this, reinforce that. Could use a decent work table where I could do all that.
Admiral Rompali once hired a specialist who made the finest armorer's tables this side of the Yeruga. I will contact him at once.
$1,000? I have like 20 grand, so this isn't a big deal.
Good. Order me up a table like that.
Immediately, sir. I expect it will take at most one day to arrive. Will you be needing anything else, sir?
Let's see here, what if I say this again? Is that literally all I can do?
Starting to get into this whole renovating thing. There must be other things we can improve.
I agree. Yet I would urge you to hold off on further construction until the ongoing work is done. Juggling can be a challenging art. It's best not to undertake too much at once.
Okay. Let's do some work on the house.
Been thinking about the outer walls. Maybe a fresh coat of paint or some patching.
If I might dare to make a suggestion, why not start with a general renovation? I once oversaw such work at Admiral Rompelli's summer residence. The effects were simply breathtaking. Not only did the residence positively sparkle afterwards, but we also made room to display the Admiral's armor and weapons, of which he was a passionate collector.
Holy 5,000! Wait, not only did the... Alright, I'm a passionate collector of armor and weapons.
It's in your hands then. Make the place shine.
I shall get to work immediately. Within a day's passing, I shall have sent for the crew which rebuffed the Admiral's residence. They are the finest specialists around. Highly skilled at what they do, it shall not take them too long, I wager. 2 days after they begin, your eyes will behold your residence in its refurbished, rejuvenated, beautified state. Is there anything else you require, sir?
Can I do more work on it?
Feels like by investing a bit of coin, I could make the house more functional.
I agree. Yet I would urge you to hold off on further construction until the ongoing work is done. Juggling can be a challenging art. It's best not to undertake too much at once.
Okay, so I think that's it.
Thanks. Gotta get back to my business now. See you soon.
Okay, so we need to wait 3 days for the general refurbishment to finish, wait 1 day for my grindstone to arrive, and wait 1 day for your armor's table to arrive. First of all, I need to hit up my stash. Is that not up here? Okay, so... Where is my stash? How do I get to my stash? Is it in here? Yes, it is. Okay, so this is... Oh! Wait. Place trophy. Oh my gosh, this is awesome. Awesome! I can take it back. The master bedroom is here. Up top here is the guest bedroom. That would make sense. Alright, so let's come back down here. I can place my fist fighting trophy here. I need to win that Gwent tournament so I can have that trophy. I don't know. I guess the other trophy is probably for horseback riding or for horse racing. Hang a painting. No items in my inventory. What else do we got here? Okay, so I can place another painting over there. Alright. Let me go ahead and stash some stuff, I guess. We're down to just under 15 grand. Not bad. Is there any weapons I actually need to stash here? I can use this thing now. I can actually use Dahlia now. Nice. Witch Hunter's swords. Okay, I don't need to store any of this crap. I do need to store those. I can't wait to be able to store armor. It's going to be awesome. Or not store armor, to showcase armor, if I listened and got that correctly. Okay, let me go ahead and put on Dahlia. Go over Havkarin. Alright, so now I can put Havkarin into the stash. Alright, there we go. Store that. I've got so much stuff to showcase, I don't even know what the heck I'm gonna do anymore. Like, what am I gonna showcase? Okay, so... So, right now, our thing is to restore Corvo Blanco to its former glory. Let's go ahead and wait. I don't think I'll do everything, like, here. Like, I'm not gonna completely restore it in this episode. But I do want to at least get one restoration done, and then we'll check... What am I doing? Hold up. There we go. Alright, so now we've got our armors, our grindstone, and our armors. So let's come down here. Where are they? Are they either in here?
I can't see a thing through these cataracts.
There we go. Alright, so now we need to wait 3 days for the general refurbishment to finish. So let's come back up to the house here. And we'll go ahead and wait. I think we need to wait one more day after this. And all of that should be done. Hopefully, I guess is what I'm saying. Hopefully it's done now. There it is, okay. The Corvo refurnishment. I'm not quite sure what happened here. I don't know. I'm not quite sure what. Oh, okay, I see it. Alright, things are a lot nicer in here. Nice and cleaned up. Oh, this looks really nice now. This is pretty awesome. What do we got over here? What's in this room? Ho-ho. Nice, the kitchen area. That's cool. We got some... Oh, there we go, a nice dining room table now. We got a smaller table over there. Armor stand. Oh, nice, armor stands going on there. There's probably... Oh, here we go, weapon stand going on here. Can put a couple swords in there. Alright, this is really cool. What can I put on these? Weapon rack? How does this work? Oh, nice. So I can display more weapons there, more weapons there. I'm extremely happy with this. This is awesome. This may have just became number one on my favorite games. Because this is pretty sweet. Alright, let's talk to him. Is there any weapon hanging or anything like that in my room? Can I show off my weapons to myself, I guess? Okay, no. They're just for outs. Oh, use. Wait, what? Whoa, books and scrolls. In this panel, you can browse through the contents of all the books and scrolls you have found. Even if you later sell a book, its contents will still be available here. Oh, that's awesome. Books on the left, you can select books, scrolls, and letters. Their contents will be shown in the center of the screen. Awesome. So that's really cool. Alright, so let's go ahead and talk to Majordomo about maybe doing some more upgrades here in this episode, then we'll call it a day.
Renovations coming along all right, Barnabas Basil?
Superbly, sir. General refurbishment has been completed, and I took the liberty of adding two racks, each upon which you might hang weapons and armor, if you've some pieces you'd like to display. Likewise, I have prepared a few spots in which new paintings might be hung. In other news, the laborers dusting out the cellar have made a most unusual discovery. I believe it's something you'll wish to see.
Right.
If you say I should see it, I'll go see it right now, BB.
Alright, so let's go search the cellar.
Every day the same wine, wine, and look like smuddling wine.
Alright, what did these...
Strange. Something behind this wall, I think.
Ah, a hidden room. Nice. What do we got? Let me put Gwen back on.
A laboratory. Must have been an alchemist at one time.
Nice! So I can dismantle the items, obviously. Upgrade basic mutagens into their more powerful versions using the alchemy panel. Find the right formula. You can also change mutagens' colors. Awesome. Is this just for dismantling? I think it is, okay. Mahakaman. Okay, so that refills my potions and bombs. Julius Von Gavve's letter. Let's go ahead and read this. To whoever finds this letter, my name is Julius Von Gavve, and if you are reading these words, I am surely long dead. As befits one of my station and familial connections, I was sent to study at Bon Art, the famed school for mages. Yet I was never to complete those studies. For the entire duration of my life, magic held but a weak hold over a soul ravished by a passion for organic alchemy. It was to that most wondrous of sciences I dedicated the most beautiful years of my life, and the table beside which you now most surely stand is the fruit of these labors of love. If you are a fellow lover of alchemy, let me roll this down, I hazard to guess you will be filled with rapture to behold my discovery. If, however, that marvelous science is unknown to you, please heed my advice. Drop this letter, step away from the table, and never return. The practice of alchemy by amateurs can lead to injury and even death. If you did not drop this letter after that last paragraph, you are no stranger to alchemy. Thus I shall now reveal to you in a brief words the fundamentals of the alchemy table I designed. Leaving aside all necessary detail, my chief discovery consisted of a formula and tools allowing for the transmutation of mutagens taken from monsters into mutagens of the more common sort. I know this sounds highly unlikely, but I have proven with utmost certainty that it is possible. Oops, let me go back up. The workings of this transmutation are simple. One must simply make use of the table which I designed as an expert in the arcane art of alchemy. You certainly already know your way around such devices. If you are but an amateur, a member of the hoi polloi, who has by accident wandered to this abandoned place, back away, lest your ignorance do your grievous harm. You are surely asking yourself why I hid my discovery from the world, why I did not share my formula with the community of alchemists. Well, let us say I have forever been regarded as eccentric, aloof, and I have always believed it is pure chance and not men themselves that determine destiny. Furthermore, I have never sired offspring and have no desire to entrust my opus to a mere acquaintance. I thus concluded the best solution was to hide my table and trust that chance will, if my theory is correct, bring a man here who shall know how to make use of it, whom it shall delight, and to whom it will prove of great use. Whether I am right or wrong, time will tell. Use my gift wisely and fare you well. Julius Bongava, Alchemist. Alright, that's pretty cool. I'm assuming we can kind of clean up this hidden room. Maybe, I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. What else is down here? I'm assuming event will touch up this down here even more. Maybe even, I don't know what else we can do here. And I wish there was kind of like something cool that would just be random quests that you could have, like, oh, have Dandelion here and have like a little festival and have him, you know, read his poetry or do something like that. Just random quests that you could have randomly pop up that you could do here, and you could actually make use of that guest room. Alright, let's go ahead and talk to Majordomo. See what other improvements we can make to the house.
Know anything about the laboratory in the cellar? One of the previous owners take an interest in alchemy?
A laboratory? Alchemy? I know nothing of it. But I understand that to a witcher this must be a very intriguing find.
It is. It was walled up. The equipment's pretty ancient too, so it must have belonged to someone who lived at Corvo Bianco before you started working here. Whoever it was sure knew their stuff though. Got dragonglass vials and flasks, stills, sublimators, vengarometers.
Forgive me, sir, but I fear I don't follow.
Just saying, it's top-notch equipment. True masterpieces of craftsmanship for use in alchemy. Brewing a concoction with this stuff versus doing it over an open fire? Well, there's no comparison.
Then I am all the more delighted you discovered it, sir.
Oh, hey, he plays... Oh, hello.
Ever play Gwent, BB?
Funny you should ask, sir. I was quite adept in my younger years, but that was so long ago. I fear I've limited my interest to collecting now. Managed to assemble quite the set of decks.
Huh. Sounds interesting. Mind showing me what you got?
Not at all, sir. But only in action. A round or two, perhaps?
May the best man win.
Do you wish to play against any particular faction, sir?
Oh, this is awesome. You can play against whatever faction you want against this guy. That is really cool that they added this. This leads to a lot of possibilities of having Gwent fun in the future. You know, you can play against whatever deck you want. You can use whatever deck you want. That's really cool.
Skellige seems most appropriate for you.
As you wish. Would you prefer I use my strongest deck or a weaker one?
Oh, this is awesome. Strongest, middle of the road, weakest. This is awesome.
Feeling lucky today. Use your strongest.
At your service, sir. Well then, Let us play.
This is amazing. This gives you endless possibilities to continue to play Gwent and have fun with it, which is really what I was asking for. You know, one day if you're feeling like playing a little Gwent, hop on here. You can play against whatever deck you want, use whatever deck you want. This is actually really awesome. Okay, not bad. Alright, so I know where I'm gonna come and play Gwent in episodes if I wanna play Gwent. Not a bad hand. Not a great hand, but it could have been worse. What does that turn him into? Oh my god! What is that? Not too bad I have the ultimate GG here. Nice try, buddy. Alright, my turn. This is really... I love this, that they added this. This is great. I'm so happy. Let's do that. Okay, he's gonna bring one of my... He's gonna bring my spy back, I would assume. Yep. Draw that back to my hand. Alright, another spy, nice. That should pretty much do it for the- oh my gosh, then I draw the other spy. Shuffle all cards. Oh, that was actually a pretty nice play. Alright, well, I won. But this is really cool. I love this, that they added this. Now let's go ahead and pass.
I congratulate you on your victory. Shall we continue playing?
Maybe later. Got something I need to do right now.
As you wish, sir.
All right.
Starting to really like this place. Maybe we should keep going, refurbish some more. What do you think, BB?
As you wish, sir. Shall we see to the house or the grounds this time?
Starting to get into this whole renovating thing. There must be other things we can improve.
What a splendidly wise idea. Now that the general refurbishment is done, why not see to the grounds? Perhaps renovate the stables? Or return Madame Bolius's garden to its former verdancy?
Well, let's give Roach his stable, which is exactly what the game is saying.
You know Roach, my horse? Well, we've been through a lot together. And since I've finally got a decent place to stay, I think she deserves one too.
Oh, a sturdy stable testifies to a most honorable owner. Just say the word, and I'll have them start working on it at once.
Bonus to horse's stamina, that's nice. 2,000? Wow, this is getting expensive.
My Roach deserves the best. Have them refurbish the stables.
I shall get to work at once. Yet finding workmen and completing construction takes time, though likely no more than 2 days. Will you be needing anything else, sir?
Let's see here.
So, sometimes I have to brew a potion. But I can't find the herbs I need growing anywhere nearby.
Well, you're in luck, sir. The flower garden, once kept by Madame Nina, Monsieur Bolius's wife, seems the ideal place to cultivate herbs. In fact, it's roomy enough to plant shrubbery.
All right, let's do it.
Good idea, Barnabas Basil. Herbs there will save me hours of painstaking searching and harvesting.
The idea is yours, sir. I am but the humble executor of your will. I believe we shall have sown the first seeds in 2 days' time. Will you be needing anything else, sir?
Let's do some more work on the house.
Feels like by investing a bit of coin, I could make the house more functional.
Indeed. Momentum is best maintained once established. Now that we've finished the general renovations, you might begin to consider such things as a new bed, or additional armor stands, or weapon racks. Also, some new furnishings and a fresh coat of paint on the walls would do much to improve the guest quarters.
Holy crap. Let's see to the guest room.
Was wondering about the guest room. Not that I'm expecting company, but...
Oh, but that is immaterial. All self-respecting homes should boast a comfortable guest room. What if someone were to drop by unannounced?
Alright, $1,000.
Yeah, sooner we start on that, the better.
I can tell a man of action immediately. I'll see to it myself. The room shall be ready in 2 days, in my opinion. Is there anything else you require, sir?
Let's get some more armor stands.
Along the path, I've often picked up well-crafted, beautifully ornamented armor. Some of those pieces would look great on display here.
I agree. It would lend the place a certain witch's air. Shall I order new stands at once, sir?
That's pretty cheap. 2 additional armor stands. Okay, cool.
Yes. Just please make sure they're solidly made and nicely finished.
It goes without saying, sir. There is nothing worse than splendid armor upon a subpar stand. By this time tomorrow, they shall be ready to display your finest finds. Is there anything else you require, sir?
Let's go ahead and get some more weapon rack.
Could use another weapon rack. Got some interesting pieces I'd like to display.
I know of a carpentry shop in town which crafts the humblest lumber into true masterpieces. You need but give the word.
Okay, 2 additional weapon racks. All right, 500.
Fine. What are the racks?
Of course, at once. At most 1 day for them to arrive is my estimation. Is there anything else you require, sir?
Let's get a better bed.
Thinking about buying a comfortable bed. Always wanted one.
Excellent idea. In your profession, rest is supremely important. But say the word, and I shall order you a bed from the carpenters who craft comfort for the court.
Bonus to vitality, nice.
Great. Order me a fine bed, please. Think I deserve one at my age.
True indeed, true indeed. I shall send a runner at once. The bet will be in place by this time tomorrow. Is there anything else you require, sir?
Know what? Changed my mind. Not in the mood to talk about redecoration today. But I wanted to ask you something else.
I shall be glad to answer your every question, sir.
Thanks. Gotta get back to my business now. See you soon.
Alright, so that is gonna do it, guys, for the first episode, or for this episode of taking a look at the house, doing some renovations. We will go continue to play through the game, and we'll come back here and check on our renovations and start new renovations as time elapses. But I'm loving this area. This is really awesome. I'm hoping there's just a crap ton of renovations that you can do and just make this awesome. Maybe even possibly add on to it. Actually doesn't look like there's a great place to add on, so it looks like the house is probably stuck at its size, but that doesn't mean we can't make this really awesome, which I'm really hoping to do. Maybe get a basement, the cellar is right underneath, but a basement may be possible, who knows, but that's gonna do it, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. Let me know what you guys think of the whole house thing. I think it's pretty awesome, but maybe I'm in a minority there. But I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Peace out.
That is mine.